place between midnight and 1 a.m. Events occur in real time.
coming. It's been 45 minutes.
Go ahead and tell us what you responded to out here tonight.
About 3:30 this morning, patrol officers received a call of shots being fired in the 3300 block of San Jose Way. Responding officers discovered one subject down in the street who had appeared to have suffered several gunshot wounds to the upper body. Ambulance crews transported the subject to UC Davis Medical Center, where he passed away a short time later. At this point, we have, unfortunately, no suspect information. And no motive, so we're scrambling for information at this point.
You don't have any car descriptions or anything to go on?
No, at this point we don't. There were several cars leaving, but we don't have anything concrete at this point.
Is there a number that the public can contact PD and get that information to them?
Yeah, absolutely. They can call either the non-emergency number at 264-5471, or they can call Crime Alert at 443-HELP.
What's the approximate age of your deceased lieutenant?
We believe in the 20s. We have not identified him yet.
Black male adult?
Yes, African American.
And just give me a little something about where the investigation goes from here.
Well, we're going to do our best to contact witnesses, apparently several of the victim's family members at the hospital. We're going to try and talk to them. They're obviously very upset at this point, so once they compose themselves, we'll hopefully get some information on the victim and kind of work backwards from there.
Was there any information as far as, was this a drive-by or was this a assailant on foot, or is there any information on
it? We have very little information. All we know is that there's some people on foot on the street, and at some point shots rang out and everybody fled.
Have you had much trouble on the street over the past year? I talked to one witness that said that she's witnessed about four shooting events.
That I can't respond to. I haven't been out in patrol for a while, so I'm a little out of touch with this particular block.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. And could you state your name and spell your last name for me? One more.
Lieutenant Michael Bray, B-R-A-Y.
Thank you very much, sir.
Hey, you bet.
Thanks, Lieutenant. Hey.
see the figures of the runner, the bicyclist, the kayaker, and obviously the symbolism of the river. And it says, this spot marks the start of Eppie's great race, an annual triathlon held the third Saturday in July. Eppie's great race has provided a source of fun and challenge for thousands of competitors from throughout the region, state, and nation. So it's dedicated to you and to your vision and to this race. Thanks a lot for all you do.
Congratulations to Eppie Johnson and the Eppie's Great Race plaque commemorating me. Now, I'm at a loss for words, really. Who would have thought that a little fun, you know, relay race would turn into a 30th annual? And it's only because dedicated folks that work on the committees and do all the hard work, I get all the glory. But it seemed like this somehow has become a Sacramento tradition. It's something that people have to work to and work for in the summertime. And we're honored that to have the plaque here. We're honored that the Board of Supervisors allows us to use the American River Parkway, which is the Sacramento's jewel, for us to stage the event. So I want to thank you all for your help, for your participation, and we'll see you here next year on the 31st.
For our therapeutic leisure program, so we thank each and every person who entered. And I do want to note, you have one big notable person here this year. Where did he go? Our ex-county assessor is actually running his first triathlon here on the Parkway, so we want to welcome him. And now we'll get on with the other festivities.
Thank you, Superman. The race starts heading west, which is away from the sun, so we need our participants behind the line. We do ask that you honor the self-seeding principle, which is that if you're not capable of starting the easy pace, Supervisor Collin, I think we are ready to begin the adaptive start. We're going to have the countdown from five, and then we will, when we hit zero, we will start our adaptive division.
Okay, our adaptive division already.
And
I'm sure that
Eppie
just didn't want to trust me with
the gun. Again, this is just the start of the adaptive division.
Unique thing. Okay, adaptive division.
We're going to make an announcement before the start of the regular race.
Four, three, two, one, go! The timers are indicating to us that we are down to our final 30 seconds. And we're down to just about 20 seconds. And then now we're going to turn the starter's microphone over again to Supervisor Isla Collin as we count down.
A peaceful race.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Woo!
Really? Really?
remove the boats, and you can see that they're in position in the water and along the shore. So great job, all of you volunteers down there. You're eager and ready to go and ready to take those boats out of the water. All right. We would really appreciate, though, if you're not one of those 100 special volunteers, and if you're a spectator, you should be out of the water. As again, there's 24 different divisions.
Doug, we're seeing our first finisher. It looks like
that'd be Dan Crandall.
Dan Crandall.
This is team number 5, multi-time winner.
Dan Crandall. Open team, 5, 6, 7. Way to go, Dan.
Overall cyclist, Jeremy Burlingame, our second place open division team. One laurel wreath and a handshake, there you go. Great fun, John Dixon said, all the way from Moss Beach. That's the team of Rose Burlingame and
Lekas and Paul Kamazi.
So this is our first place in the tandem kayak division, our third team through the finish line. Team Current Adventures, another one of our longtime teams. These three participants have participated in many different great races and very successfully.
Team 848, this looks like John Weed. It is Team 848.
Team Current Adventures, and that was 91 that crossed the line. Here comes Team Current Adventures. Yeah, there's two Current Adventure teams back to back, and that was Tandem Canoe 91, and here's Team number 848, that's John Weed.
That's a team of
men's 40 and over, excuse me.
Frank Thomas, Chris Dominguez, and John Weed. John Weed, long time race supporter, many time winner.
John Weed, we know this finish line this year is particularly notable for you. Tell us what it feels like to cross the line again.
Oh God, it looks so good each year. It's wonderful. I was hoping I could catch that other Current Adventures double. They had too much juice.
Congratulations again to John Weed, Current Adventures 40 and over team division. The family division for this year was renamed the Leonard Star Weed Memorial Division in honor of his father, longtime Eppie's Great Race participant. This will be our first family team, Eppie. This is the Hanna family. You read about them in the program. Rich Hanna, the runner and the cyclist, and Bob Hanna, the paddler. Once again, Team Hanna crosses the finish line, first place in the family division, this year renamed the Leonard Star Weed Division.
Doug, ask Bob if he'll tell us how old he is.
Division, now the Leonard Star Weed Memorial Division.
Well, the John Roos are coming up, and they're going to take it either next year or again, like they did last year. The toughest competition we ever faced.
Tough. Or a name recognition.
Vic Vicari. Last year's winner repeats. Last year's fastest Ironman repeats.
At 1 hour, 45 minutes, and 35 seconds, this is our 2003 30th annual Ironman champion, Vic Vicari. Vic Vicari from Sacramento, repeat Ironman champion. Vic, how does it? Tell us about your race, Vic. How was it out there?
It was tough. The run and bike were okay, but the wind's blowing pretty good. Made the kayak pretty tough.
Any Ironman close to you at the race, or do you think you had it all to yourself?
No, I think Don Hicks is.
Don Hicks is right here.
He's always
right behind.
Always a challenge. So I figured he'd pass me in the end, but I guess I got him there.
You held him off. Congratulations, Vic Vicari, and here comes Don Hicks, 12-time Ironman champion, finished the second in the 30th. Eppie's Great Race. Don Hicks, 1:46:30, raced him all the way to the line.
How'd you do?
Don, congratulations. Second place, tell us about the race.
It was a long run. I'm a lot of shape by the run. He really had a good run.
four. Panel sit on top. Brian Packer, Leslie Miller, and John South.
Okay,
Bob,
better
bring your
four.
What's that, Charlie?
That's 4 rounds of fries. Oh, yeah, yeah. Actually, we're headed there tonight.
Way, and that he was probably going about 100 miles an hour up this street, and then he hit her head on, and then she was next, and that middle car, that lady's dead, no doubt about it.
So the cream color, the Lexus, was going the wrong way?
Yes.
Did it pass you?
No, I was coming up right after it happened, so.
And a lady told us to call 911.
Yeah.
So we pulled over.
So you went by the accident after it happened and
right,
stopped?
Right.
Scary?
Yes, and this is a good lesson for Elizabeth, because she's going to be 14, and I want her to see. This guy, I believe, from what I saw when I looked in the car, his pants were down, and he had porno paraphernalia in the car, like he was drunk and doing something he shouldn't have been doing, going down the wrong way to begin with. So I want her to see what happens out here. That
even though you're careful yourself, or you could be endangered by somebody
that's
else.
That's right. Yeah.
You ever see anything like this?
I was in a nearly fatal car accident, broke my pelvis, so I.
First-hand experience.
Yeah.
Did you actually see the car coming?
I didn't see him coming, no, because I was behind there.
Oh, really?
Right after, I was next, so.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So you stopped just in time?
Right.
Could you tell me your name and spell your last name?
Pam Mood, M-O-O-D.
Thank you, Pam.
Okay.
Where are you from?
Thank you.
My bike.
Tim, yes, barely missed him.
What did you see as you came up over the bridge?
All I know is that we were just driving. I saw the lady that took the head on, swerve over towards us to get out of the way, and that's when we moved over, and then the white car just came. The white car came like a flash of light. I did not see it. Luckily, the driver, luckily she alerted us, because otherwise that was us. Because we saw her coming over towards us, and that gave us a reason to move over. But I don't think she had maybe a second before she moved, and then she was nailed. That car, I don't know how fast that car must have been going, but it had to have been going just, first of all, where did he jump on at?
How many ladies in there?
I don't know, man, I don't know. I don't even want to think about it. Hopefully just one, but.
And it was quite a violent crash.
Oh, it was horrible. I look back and I'm like, that person's dead. And I thought he hit the tail end of our car, but it looked like they didn't, but the only reason we are alive right now is because that lady swerved towards us. And it's sad to think that now she's dead, but what the hell was he doing?
Could you tell me your name and spell your last name, please?
Yeah, my name's Doug Woodward, W-O-O-D-W-A-R-D.
Thank you, Doug.
What's that?
Big loop right back here if you can.
Hey, how you doing?